Today I will talk about relational operators in C programming. In yesterday I started the operator concept in C. Okay, I explained different types of the operators. Okay, arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator, assignment operator, then conditional operator or ternary operator, and bitwise operators. Okay, size of operator, comma operator. Yesterday I talked about arithmetic operators with the help of the example also. In today, I will explain about relational operators in C. First, I want to tell you what is the relational operator. Okay, what is the importance of the relational operator? Why should you use relational operators in any programming languages? The relational operators are used to compare one operand with another operand. Okay, it is used to compare the one operand with another operand. Because one operand, for example, A should be compared with B. I have taken two variables, A and B. Okay, A less than B or A greater than B, A greater than or equal to B. Because one operand is comparing with the another operand. Okay, if the condition is true, which returns false. The condition is false, which returns zero. Isn't it? But what are the relational operators? Okay? Yeah. C provides various relational operators . The first one is what is called less than . Okay, what is the symbol? Then greater than, what is called less than or equal, less than or equal, greater than or equal, greater than or equal, then phi equal, then 6 not equal. Because these operators are called as what? Relational operators. Why should you use the relational operator? Because you want to compare one operand with the another operand. Here, if you want a relation operator, you must require two operands. Okay, it is also called the binary relations. Okay, a less than, greater than, less than or equal, greater than or equal, equal and not equal. How should we compare these? For example, x value is 10, suppose y value is 5. How should we compare one operand with the another operand? Okay, look at here, x less than y, x greater than y, x less than or equal to y, but x greater than or equal to y, x equal to y, x not equal to y. Because x is the operand, because it is the operand, then y is the operand, because x operand is compared with the one y operand. Because whenever using the relational operator, it must require two operands. Okay, the x is the first operand is comparing with the y operand. Okay, x less than y. What is the x value is given over here? X value is 10. Y value is what? 5. 10 less than 5. And the condition is true or false. X less than 5, because 5 is smaller than 10. But in this condition, y should be bigger, because condition is false. If condition is false, what it returns? It returns 0. Okay, whether condition is true, which returns 1. If condition is false, which returns 0. Remember it. Then here, what is the h value is 5, 10, 5. Because 10 greater than 5. Because condition is true. At this time, which returns 1. Hope it is clear. Here, x less than or equal to y. What is the h value? 10. Then 5. Less than or false. Condition is false, which returns 0. X greater than or equal to, because it is equal. If it is 10, y value is also 10, condition is true. But y value is what? 5. Because condition is false. Then here, x value is 10, y value is 5, x greater than or equal to 5. Yeah, condition is true, which returns 1. But x equal to y. Okay, what is x equal to y? But x value becomes 10, y value becomes 5. Because both are not equal. Then which returns 0. Here it is 10, it is 5. 10 not equal to 5 is obvious true. Because which returns 1. Because these examples are about the what? Relational operators. Because how the one operand should be compared with the other operand. It is less than or greater than. Less than or equal. Or greater than or equal. Then what is x equal? X not equal to y. That is the importance of. It is plays very important role in any programming languages. Okay. Whenever you use the loops concept or condition statements. Which takes very important role. Because whenever you compare with the two operands. We should require the what? Relational operators. What are the relational operators? These are called as the what? Relational operators. Hope it is clear. Then I am going to write the example for the relational operators. Example, then ash include stdio.h. It is common for all because it is a file is required to get the input or output. Then void main, just wait a second. Then marker has completed. Then write main. What is next? Suppose I want to take int x is 10, then y is 5. Hope it is clear. Or else you want to read these values from the input device by using the scanf function. Okay. Then here. Printf x less than y equal here percentile d x less than y printf x greater than y because x greater than y. End of the statement, you must put a semicolon. Then print of x less than or equal percentile d x less than or equal to y. Then print of x greater than or equal percentile d comma x greater than or equal to y print of x equal to y equal, then x equal to y, then print of x not equal and equal to y. Here this is called a string constant. For our understanding purpose I written this statement, or else you can directly write percentile d x less than y. Okay, percentile d x greater than y, direct you can write it, there is no problem. For our understanding purpose I written this string constant. Okay, whatever written within the double quotes, the same should be displayed on the output device. Here for example, what is the output you will get? Here x less than y equal x greater than y equal x less than r equal y equal x greater than r, then equal means then x, what is written, equal to y equal, then x not equal to, first all these whatever is written within the double quotes all should be displayed on the output device. Then after that x less than y, because it is 10 it is y, condition is, sorry, here first I have 10 5, condition is false then 0, here condition is true 1, here condition is false 0, here condition is true 1, here condition is false 0, here condition is true 1. Here what is the output you will, if you compile this program, this is the output you are going to get for the relational operators. I hope it is clear. Next video I will talk about logical operators and assignment operators. Okay, if it is not clear, please ask your query in, or else you can post your query in comment box window. Thank you, thank you, and thank you for watching my video.